Unfortunately, I've written and talked a very great deal on the subject, and I say unfortunately because I'd have to spend the next 10 hours talking about this. Linda Palmer Nochlin wrote a book called Why Are There No Great Women Artists? And she asked the question, why are there no great Lithuanian jazz musicians? Now, there's several ironies here. First of all, some artists who were great, people did not know they were women. And we know that in our times and 19th century, it was very difficult for women because in art schools, they were not allowed to go to life drawing classes. Now, you couldn't really get to be a great artist without drawing nudes, and they were denied this experience. So that's one of the ironies. Of course, the Lithuanian jazz player irony is that Al Jolson was the original jazz player, and he was a Lithuanian. So there's the second irony there. But what she meant is situation and opportunity condition what you can do. And so that is part of the story. Another part of the story is that there have indeed been famous, or rather great women mm-hmm. architects, but who did not become famous or who were lost. And not very many, we have to admit, but there were. And then we went through a very quiescent period in the 1950s here, where Rosie the Riveter was knocked back out of the factory into the kitchen, and women are also lost ground in the professions in general.
It is interesting, though, that there have been historically not a lot, but more women writers, for instance, than women architects. So there are some.
Well, I'm coming to that.
Things of that sort.
I'm coming to that. My mother studied architecture, and this was not looked upon as unusual in the 20s, at least not as unusual as it would have been in the 50s in America. I didn't think it was unusual for a woman to study architecture. But now, when I got into the field as a young woman at the Architectural Association and in South Africa, you were of interest because you were a woman, and what woman wouldn't take advantage of that? The first time I hit the notion of discrimination was when I went with my other friends, we all idealistic young architects, up to Scotland to interview a certain Egon Rees, head of the Scottish Coal Board, who was doing wonderful brutalist architecture. And we loved the work he was doing. And he was interviewing us for jobs. And he said to me, well, of course, you would be paid less than the men. I can't pay you more because I would make the secretaries jealous. And the joy went out of it for me. There's no way I was ever going to work for him. Anyway, I have a feeling he wasn't a very nice guy either, but that's another matter. But so that was the first time I met that, and that was 1953, 54, something like that.